brought to you by Gitanjali Salon, Channi Himmat, Jammu. Follow Ruchika Makeovers on Facebook and Instagram for best bridal makeup in town.
Hello viewers, you are watching Jammu Links News. I am Manat Gupta and welcome to the daily updates of Midday News. Let's begin.
Jammu and Kashmir witnessed the biggest single-day spike in COVID-19 cases on Wednesday, with 162 people testing positive for the disease, raising the tally to 1,921. The Union Territory also reported two fresh coronavirus-related deaths, while 38 of these cases are from Jammu, 124 are from Kashmir. The total number of cases in the UT has now reached to 1,921. Retaliating that restriction on the internet speed have not posed any hindrance to COVID-19 control measures, assessing online education or carrying out business activities, the Department of Home J&K Government today ordered the continuance of 2G mobile data services only till June 17 in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. An order in this regard was issued today by Principal Secretary Home Department Charlene Kabra, according to which the internet speed on mobile data services shall remain restricted to 2G only till June 17, 2020, unless modified earlier. With 6,566 more coronavirus cases and 194 deaths reported in the past 24 hours, India's COVID-19 tally reached 1,58,333 on Thursday, according to the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. The number of active coronavirus cases stands at 86,110, while 67,692 people have recovered and one patient has migrated, it said. The death toll due to the infection has reached 4,531 in the country. There is no need to panic due to the spike in the novel coronavirus infections in Jammu and Kashmir, Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh told health workers on Monday, adding that the cases were not only being traced but treated effectively in quarantine facilities. Singh said the increase in the cases of the coronavirus disease was expected due to the large number of people returning to the state. The Minister of State for Personnel was reviewing the status of the COVID-19 pandemic in the Union Territory. About 15 domestic flights with 1,289 passengers on board arrived at Jammu-Srinagar airports on day 3 of resumption of the air services in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. A total of 217 passengers aboard 7 flights, including one charter air travel, arrived at the Jammu airport, while 8 flights with about 1,072 passengers on board landed at Srinagar airport today. After arrival, all the passengers were tested for the COVID-19 virus and transported to their destinations at both the airports amid strict observance of all necessary preventive protocols. The administration ensured that all passengers use masks and follow social distancing, hand and respiratory hygiene. Moderate rains lashed Jammu city as the sky turned dark this morning, bringing much needed relief from the scorching heat wave that continued in the winter capital for the past few days. Today's shower has brought down the day temperature from 38 degrees Celsius to 26. Agriculture experts believe that today's rainfall would be beneficial for the crops and fruits in the region. Union HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank on Wednesday said that the Central Board of Secondary Education has decided to allow students who went back to their home states to give their board examinations in schools located in their respective districts. He said that the decision was taken keeping in mind the students who had returned to their homes during the lockdown imposed to contain the further spread of COVID-19 pandemic. US President Donald Trump on Wednesday waded into the tense border standoff between India and China, saying he was ready, willing, and able to mediate between the two sides. Trump, who has in the past repeatedly offered to mediate between India and Pakistan on the issue of Kashmir and been rebuffed, made the latest offer through a tweet. He also said he had informed India and China of his offer. Principal Secretary, Agriculture Production Department, Naveen Kumar Chaudhary has emphasized on growth of farm economy by enhancement of agriculture production. He was chairing a meeting to discuss and review annual action plan under National Food Security Mission for the year 2020-21. The principal secretary stressed on the need for increasing production of rice, wheat, pulses and cereals through area expansion. He sought productivity enhancement in a sustainable manner in the identified districts of the Union Territory. The cultural face of Jammu and Kashmir Pandit Bhajan Sopuri has made a new raga, Hemrast, which is a beautiful combination of Raga Hemant of Indian classical and Mukam Raste Kashmiri of Sufiana Mosiki. Titled as the Saint of Santur, Pandit Sopuri represents the 300-year-old mystical musical Shivite Sufi tradition of Sopuri Sufiana Gharana of Kashmir, which is a blend of Sufiana Mosiki, Hindustani classical music as well as a spiritual side with expertise in sound therapy. Principal Secretary Power Development Department Rohit Kansal on Wednesday discussed the modalities for implementation of smart meter installation project and execution of annual maintenance contract for IT infrastructure created under RAP DRP Part A at a meeting. Kansal, who is also chairman of Jammu Kashmir Power Distribution Corporation Limited, also reviewed the overall functioning of JPDCL and KPDCL. The meeting decided that the implementation of smart metering would be started from July 2020 and the hardware along with software solution for it would be provided by REC PDCL. Advisor to Lieutenant Governor Basir Ahmed Khan visited Mubarak Mandi Heritage Complex to inspect the progress of renovation works being carried out for its conservation. The advisor went round the heritage complex and sought details about the status of the work from the concerned functionaries. He directed to constitute a progress review committee which shall analyze the work progress on regular basis and submit the report to the board for further review. District Administration Samba on Wednesday sent migrant labourers to Katra for their further journey to their home states. Over 1,633 persons, all from Chhattisgarh, were sent in a fleet of 55 buses from the three different dispatching points in the district. Deputy Commissioner Samba Rohit Khajuria informed that breakfast, tea and snacks were provided to the stranded people, while packaged food and water was provided with them for travel. A major terror plot was averted in Jammu and Kashmir after the security forces recovered a car laden with an improvised explosive device in South Kashmir's Pulwama district. The explosive laden car was said to be placed at a strategic location to target a security forces convoy or a defense installation. The explosive was kept in a blue drum inside the car. A bomb disposal squad reached the spot on Thursday morning. People were asked to move away from the vicinity. The bomb disposal squad then, instead of defusing the explosive, exploded the vehicle. Nearly 95,420 J&K residents have been evacuated by the Jammu and Kashmir government via Lakhanpur and through a network of special trains and buses till date amid strict observance of all necessary guidelines and standard operating procedures aimed at safe and comfortable passage of stranded residents in the wake of COVID lockdown. As per the official data received in this regard, the administrations of Jammu and Kashmir districts have received 34 COVID special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway stations from different states and UTs so far, with about 27,512 stranded passengers, while about 67,908 persons have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date.